This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. All right, we're continuing to graph trig functions, and we're going to do this problem, which really brings everything together for a sine function, y equals 4 sine of 3x minus pi over 2 plus 1. So we want to find the amplitude, period, phase shift, and the vertical shift, and then graph this function. Okay, so we're going to need to find out the amplitude, the period, the phase shift, and the vertical shift. All right, the amplitude is fairly simple. It's the coefficient here, so that's going to be 4. The vertical shift, I'm adding 1, so it's positive, so we're going to go up 1 unit. So those are the easiest ones to figure out. Now what about the period? Remember, the period is 2 pi divided by the coefficient of x, which is 3, right? So for the period, since b equals 3, the period will be 2 pi divided by b, or 2 pi over 3. So now we've got the period. That's going to be 2 pi over 3. That's one way to get the period using that formula. And the last thing we need to do is the phase shift. So for the phase shift, remember we take what's in the parentheses and we set it equal to 0. Okay? So for the phase shift, we take that 3x minus pi over 2, and you set it equal to 0. So you have to solve for x. There's more than one way to solve for x, but I'm going to just add pi over 2 to both sides. And then I've got 3x, so I'm going to multiply both sides by the reciprocal of 1/3, so that I don't have a complex fraction on the right. And that tells me that x equals, well, the sine would be positive, pi over 6. So the shift is pi over 6 units to the right. So our next step is to figure out the ordered pairs that will be on this graph. And remember, for y equals sine of x, these are the 5 key points, right? So we need to find the 5 key points for ours. Now notice the phase shift is pi over 6 units to the right. So our first x coordinate will be the 0 plus pi over 6. So our first coordinate will be pi over 6. So you know that if you are going to make the chart over here, the first one will be pi over 6. Now we may want to change the denominator of that depending on the period and what the next x coordinate is going to be. Alright, so how do we get the next coordinate? Well, since the period is 2 pi over 3, since the period is 2 pi over 3, we have to only go 1/4 of the way there to get the next x-coordinate. So the next x-coordinate would be the pi over 6, right, plus 1/4 of that 2 pi over 3, right? And then we go 2/4 of 2 pi over 3, 3/4 of pi over 3, 4/4 of pi over 3 would be your last x-coordinate, and 4/4 is the same as just 2 pi over 3, so hopefully that makes sense. And let's see, we can cancel here, and how convenient, when I cancel, both fractions have a common denominator. So what I've got is pi over 6 plus pi over 6, right? That gives me pi over 6 plus pi over 6. which is 2 pi over 6, and I'm going to leave it like that, 2 pi over 6, because this is helping me see what to use on the increments on the x-axis. I'm going to do it in terms of sixths. Okay, now you could add pi over 6 again to get the third one, right? You just keep adding pi over 6, so the next one will be 3 pi over 6. The next one will be 4 pi over 6. And the next one will be 5 pi over 6. That's one way to get your key points. There are other ways as well. I just find this the easiest. Okay, so what that means is from pi over 6 to 5 pi over 6, that should be a full 2 pi over 3 units. So if you subtract the larger number minus the smaller, 5 pi over 6 minus pi over 6, you get 4 pi over 6, which actually is 2 pi over 3. So make sure that that's a full 2 pi over 3 units from the first key x-coordinate to the last key x-coordinate. Right now we have to deal with this with the y-values. Right, so it's the phase shift and the period that help you determine the x-coordinates. Now we want to know what 4 sine of 3x minus pi over 2 plus 1 is. So what am I doing to all the y-values? Well, that's like your y values that you see over here. By choosing these x coordinates, if I were just doing the sine of 3x minus pi over 2, I would have gotten these five coordinates, 0, 1, 0, negative 1, 0. But instead, I'm going to have to multiply by 4 and add 1. All right, so I'm going to have to do 4 times something and then add 1, 4 times something and 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 add 1, and what are those that I'm doing it to? These key y-coordinates over here. 0, 1, 0, negative 1, 1. You could do that in your head, of course. And let's see what each of those simplifies to. That's 0 plus 1 or 1. 4 plus 1 is 5. 0 plus 1 is 1. Negative 4 plus 1 is negative 3. And 4 plus 1 is 5. So now we've got 5 key points. Pi over 6, 1, 2 pi over 6, 5, etc. And of course, I always suggest that you really put in one of these x-coordinates into the original function and simplify all the way through yourself and make sure you get the y-coordinate over here. I'm going to skip showing that. But for instance, you could put in this 3 pi over 6 is like the same as pi over 2. So you could plug pi over 2 in for x into the original function and simplify in the parentheses, take the sine of your answer, multiply it by 4, add 1, and hopefully you will get 1. So now we're ready to graph. All right, so here are our ordered pairs, and now we're ready. So we have to decide where on the x-axis we're going to put these points. And notice it's all in sixths, right? So, and they're all in the positive direction. So I'm going to make sure there's enough room over to the right. Oops, so I want to make that black. There we go. Okay. All right, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It's not very straight. Let me make this a little bit straighter. All right, so let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That would be 6 pi over 6, so I'm going to call that pi. All right, and then we can go to the left. 2, 3, 4, 5. All right, so we're only going negative 5 in that direction. And then, now, what about on the y-axis? What do I need? The lowest point is negative 3. The highest point is 5, so I've got to make sure I've got at least 3 down. So I'll just say that that is negative 4 and up 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's say that's 6. All right, so let's graph these key points. We have pi over 6, 1. Oops. Okay, pi over 6, you'll only go one space over and up 1. So there's our starting point. We go over 2 pi over 6 up 5. 3 pi over 6, 1, down here again. 4 pi over 6, negative 3. And 5 pi over 6. You know, I think I did that wrong. I think it's 1 at the end. Let's look it, because that's not going to make sense to go up to 5. Oh, found my mistake. I did 4 times 1 right here. This should have been a 0. And then 0 plus 1 is 5. I'm sorry, 0 plus 1 is 1. Okay, so that was the wrong order pair. Often you'll find you made some arithmetic mistake once you start graphing it. And so there we are, 5 pi over 6, 1. All right, now you can hopefully see that is the usual sine curve. And you just try to make it as accurate as possible. All right, and that should be, it's a little more than 1 cycle. Of course, if you go to the left, it should be down here again. Negative 3, and then back up here at 1, and then up here, and then down here. So if you kept on going, you can get another cycle. All right. Now remember, we said the amplitude was 4, and look at it. The amplitude is 4 from the center, right? You're up 4 and then below 4. So it makes this, if you look at it, it's true the amplitude is 4. And we had that the phase shift was pi over, I think it was pi over 6 to the right. And notice it's like the sine starts pi over 6 to the right. And then we had the vertical shift of up 1. First ship was up 1, and yes, the whole thing is sort of like up from the x-axis, up 1 space, and then our period was 2 pi over 3. In between 0 and 2 pi over 3 is 1 full cycle. You could look from 0 to here, that's 1 full cycle, that's 2 pi over 3. You think 1 pi over 3, 2 pi over 3, 3 pi over 3, or in between this point and this point. All right, so that all makes sense. Let's also just go ahead and write the domain and range. The domain, what are the values x can take on? Always the same for the sine, anything. So it's negative infinity to infinity. And what's the range? That's the bottom and the top point. So the very lowest point is negative 3, and the very top point is 5. Whoops. And there we have it. So if you could do this problem, you're really getting there. Now if it was negative 4 in front of here, the whole thing would be flipped. For instance, remember when it's a minus sign first, because all your answers would have been multiplied by negative 4 first. So everything would have been flipped. It would have gone down first starting at this point. So for instance, this would have been what it looked like if we had if we had negative 4. Okay, so be careful if you have the minus sign in front that you catch that.
This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.